Kia ora, katoa. My name is Heather Gunter, and I've been part of the Perioperative Steering Committee for a few years now. I'm a consumer on the committee, but I'm also a registered nurse. I've lived through the tragedy of losing a son following a simple appendectomy, something you never expect to happen. At the time when I was asked to join, I was actually giving a lot of talks around the country to healthcare professionals about how we can make the whole perioperative area safer. So Vanessa, who was chair at the time, asked me to join as a consumer to give my perspective.
The last thing they need is for things to go wrong, and they trust us to do things properly for them and to do have their best interests at heart, and we do. But we can do better. We can easily do better by just communicating and collaborating properly with each other. And we're going to do that. We are going to make it better for patients.
You make better decisions by talking to each other, by communicating, not by documenting in the electronic medical record, not by seeing somebody sequentially, but actually some of the best decisions you make are the decisions that you make with your colleagues.
Perioperative medicine to me is all about getting the right patient, having the right operation at the right time in the right place. The goal is to decrease risk and complications for patients undergoing surgery.
So there are data emerging to show that excellent care, often driven by anaesthetists, but supported by physicians, geriatricians, surgeons, and allied health, can make a massive difference.
A better informed and skilled GP with knowledge of perioperative medicine shall add enormous value to the patient.
I think cross-specialty learning is crucial and essential to the working of perioperative medicine. The movement away from siloed care to a more collaborative approach.
So the aim of perioperative medicine is not necessarily to break down those silos, but to actually build bridges between those silos.
Anaesthetists are at the forefront of perioperative medicine, and they've taken the lead in perioperative medicine. This is exciting because surgeons relay these patients or refer these patients to anaesthetists, and often where the physicians are not aware. So having an anaesthetist on leading this is the bridge to surgeons and geriatricians coming together, so it closes that gap.
I always use the analogy of a conductor and the orchestra. And what we've had up until now is all the different instruments, the strings playing by themselves and the brass playing by themselves. And what we're developing now is the conductor of the orchestra, the perioperative medicine clinician, who will bring everyone together to produce an orchestra that sounds absolutely fantastic, because up until now it has sounded pretty disjointed.
So to be clear, we're not trying to make geriatricians into anaesthetists or anaesthetists into intensivists, but we're actually trying to, if you like, fill in the unknowns that people may not be aware of, so that the patient has got a coordinator that will coordinate their journey through.
It delivers better outcomes. It delivers better outcomes for patients when we work together in a collaborative manner. But it also saves money, and it comes back to that old adage that actually better care costs less. There is an economic argument to support a much more collaborative approach to the surgical journey.
Well, as the person who led the REASON study, the large observational study across Australia and New Zealand, where we found that the rates of complications are approximately 1 in 5 patients in older patients having major surgery, and mortality of 1 in 20 within 30 days of surgery.
About a third of the patients admitted to intensive care come as a result of following elective surgery. So it's quite a large resource implication on ICU.
So we know that between 1 in 4 to 1 in 6 patients who undergo elective surgery will have a complication. And these complications have huge impacts on patient well-being, things like length of stay, and ultimately cost to the health service.
In fact, what we find is that for every patient that we treat for one day, we free up 4 beds.
The college diploma will be the first in the world to actually be a clinical diploma, whereby we have a combination of clinical face-to-face experience, which participants will go through, as well as online learning.
The pre-existing qualifications in perioperative medicine are predominantly theory-based at the moment, and I think this will really give people the practical skills that they need to be an excellent practitioner.
The standard setting that's provided by the diploma means that there is more common ground and more common language between the members of the team, which reduces opportunities for error and increases opportunities for synergy.
We've watched the diploma evolve over time. We've had geriatricians provide input into the content of the modules. The flexibility of the way the modules are evolving is a very positive thing. The perioperative medicine diploma will cater for more than one discipline interested in working in the perioperative space, and as an acknowledgement that more than one discipline needs to work in the perioperative medicine space.
Speaking from a surgeon's perspective, I think we want every surgeon to be interested and to be involved in this, because it is important for them to see the benefits of going through this process and how this course will benefit the optimal outcome of our surgical patients.
Once the diploma becomes widely accepted and people are actually qualifying with the diploma, I think the communication between the various craft groups will improve significantly.
The collaboration has managed to put everybody in the same room, putting aside their own preconceived ideas of what a good outcome is, and getting the same outcome, the same idea of that outcome that the patient wants, as well as what we want and how we can achieve it. It's just been amazing to work with those smart people who are all so committed to do that.
We'll know that this has been successful when perioperative medicine is used as a routine phrase in public discussion about healthcare, the health budget. If we hear the health minister, or ideally the prime minister, use the phrase perioperative medicine, and the metric of mortality within 30 days of surgery being seen to be an important one.
It was something I wanted to be a part of, and to see it come into fruition now, it's amazing. It really is.